In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our brothers and sisters, we have come rejoicing into the house of the Lord for the celebration that we stand with Dominic and Chanel on the day they intend to form a home of their own. For them, this is a moment of unique importance. So let us support them with our affection, with our friendship, and with our prayer as their brothers and sisters. And let us listen attentively with them to the word that God speaks to us today. Then with all the church, let us humbly pray to God the Father through Christ our Lord for this couple, his servants, that he lovingly look and accept them, bless them, and make them always one.
Listen, great pastor. brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and makes cloth with skillful hands. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice.
Kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you've learned and received, and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. Today, especially wedding days, regardless of the weather or the company, I would say it's hard to not be joyful. You notice in the second reading, we rejoice always, have joy, and seeing Chanel and Dominic, even the bride's face look good compared to the groomsmen today, but you know, they're great guys and wonderful family members for both Chanel and Dominic as we celebrate their holy matrimony. It's a big joy, and I think 7 or 8 years ago I met Chanel here at this cathedral. We were standing in line for confession, and then I know her grandparents were married here, and I also know that her parents were married here, and now she's being married here at this cathedral here in Reno to Dominic. And they also said maybe a lot of you aren't Catholic. It's all right, welcome here in the church as we celebrate this Mass, and maybe some of you are used to quick weddings, and you're like, oh, it's a Catholic wedding, it's going to be quite long and everything, and it is. It'll be all right, though. I think afterwards, the beer and the wine will flow quite well, and you'll be like, you'll just remember Dominic's face, why Chanel walked down to him, always one of the best parts of the meeting at the weddings. And when we think of weddings, oftentimes we could say love is in the air, right? In our culture, I would say, we define, we have love, and then we have love, right? And when we think of love in this second sense, this romantic, the
It's been physical, very intimate. There's nothing wrong with that. That's necessary, but our faith, especially here in Mass, calls us to go beyond that. Right? So when Dominic gives his vows to his soon-to-be wife, and Chanel gives her vows to her soon-to-be husband, they are professing not just their romantic love for one another, but something that goes beyond it, to will the good of the other. And I think stories are helpful to hash out these different things that our language falls short of describing. I'm sure most of you have heard of the Humane Society, right? Humane Society, cats and dogs, it's really great. But I want to talk to you about the first Humane Society. And this goes back to 1700s. The island of Nantucket, northeastern part of our country, close to Canada, up in Canada. And the island looks northeast of the Atlantic. And back then, the first Humane Society started. If you can imagine, I can't imagine anyone's been to Nantucket, but if you are, then we'll have a beer after another reception. You can imagine ships coming in, and there's horrible rocks there, and the storms would be very severe. And the Humane Society was set up in this village to go after shipwrecked sailors. They came in, so if you can imagine, storms, the weather, horrific. And they set up what they're called huts of refuge, about every 50 to 100 meters on this island. So when the storms were bad, especially in the winter, and they knew a boat was coming in, they would all sit out there, the Humane Society, in these huts of refuge. And when they would see a ship coming on, it would crash on the rocks, they were ordered to go out in their rowboats to try to save someone. Think about this. This is just beyond simple niceness or kindness. This is heroism. And something to keep in mind is they didn't even know if anyone had survived. So these men would get in rowboats, sometimes in the dead of winter, to row out to see if they could save someone's life. Their motto was, you have to go out, but you don't have to come back. You have to go out, but you don't have to come back. I think of this, you have to go out, but you don't have to come back. I think it's a motto that's fitting for any life of vocation where you're called to give yourself completely. Marriage, it's not 50% Chanel, 50% Dominic. Or 80% Chanel, 20% Dominic. I've never been married, but I can ask some of you guys, I don't think that would work well. It is, I'm going to give myself fully to you, and I don't expect anything back. I'll go out, but I don't have to come back. Chanel is giving my full self, your full self to Dominic, not expecting anything in return, but this love that you're professing today in front of this whole church, know that Dominic feels the same. So instead of getting more of yourself back, you are receiving your husband and Dominic in turn, your wife. You have to go out, but you don't have to come back. You won't be the same person after today. You notice in the gospel, the two become one flesh. Dominic, you will soon be, if not already, but even more so in a more mystical sense. So united to your wife that when you show up somewhere, they'll ask, well, where's your wife? And Chanel, you'll be so united with Dominic that when you go somewhere and Dominic's not there, you say, well, where's your husband? Because the two are one, giving yourself completely, expecting nothing in return except the love of the other. And it's not the simple romantic love that putters and dies and goes away after a few months, but rather one that you'll go out in the lifeboats, even if you're unsure there is a life to be saved because you gave your word on this afternoon here in Reno. When you get to these vows, they'll say, through sickness and in health, right, the good times and the bad. When human love fails, and it often does, this is where our Mass comes in today. Oftentimes, I'm sure many of you have been to different weddings, maybe in a park or nice settings up in Tahoe, something like that, nothing wrong with that. But here, Catholic Mass. Why Mass? Well, because when that human love fails, is where Dominic and Chanel are looking to rely on the
the divine life. First reading, charm and beauty are deceptive and fleeting. St. Paul goes on to say that love never fails, not this romantic love, but rather one that gives your life for another. So here in Mass, one thing, I mean, there are several, but maybe perhaps the main thing that separates a Catholic wedding from other weddings is, in the context of Mass, we believe Mass is one full prayer, with either music, the different readings, and then the prayers that have to come. One full prayer, encapsulating both the bride and the groom, we pray with them. It goes on further, that when we receive communion here as Catholics, we don't simply believe it's symbolic or a sign of Jesus, but rather we believe it is Jesus' body, blood, soul, and divinity. You'll see those Catholics kneeling down, reception of communion. Here we have Jesus on the cross to my right, and above him the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Jesus dying for the love of each human being to ever exist. Wants to make us as the bridegroom dying for his spouse. It's Dominic dying for Chanel. Chanel dying for Dominic. Dominic, the perfect image is Jesus dying for his church. You have to go out, but you don't have to come back, because the more you give of yourself, yes, you will lose yourself, but what you will become through God's grace and the love of your spouse is much more than you will lose. So as we go on with this Mass, we celebrate Dominic, Chanel. We're here with their family members and their closest friends, and we could really look at our own lives, what I'm called to do. Am I loving as those in a humane society? I gotta go out, but I don't want to come back. And oftentimes, we fall short. So when that is, we come to weddings like today where Chanel and Dominic give us hope that love is still there, that love hasn't died, that romance is there. At the same time, it doesn't stay there, because with Christ's sacrifice on the cross, we're here to commemorate. We know that it's only a participation in that sacrifice of Christ. Because it's a participation, each one of us, not yes, specifically today, Dominic and Chanel, each one of us, are called to give more fully of ourselves to will the good of the other. So Dominic and Chanel, I really congratulate you on today. Your family, your friends, the groomsmen have been great guys so far. They like to make jokes in the back as well. The ladies haven't talked to them as much, but I look forward to talking more after the reception. And just know, today, as you go out, don't have to come back, because you'll be losing yourself to your partner. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the house of the church so that in the presence of Christ, minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord and the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you through a special sacrament. He enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Dominic and Chanel, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly? Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy marriage, join your right hand and declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Dominic, take you now to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
May the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the God who joined together our first parents in paradise, strengthen and bless in Christ the consent you have declared before the church, so that when God joins together, no one may put asunder. Now I ask the rings.
Should I receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity? In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, I invite you all to now stand. As we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God is pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Chanel and our brother Dominic, let us commend them to the Lord. The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. That these faithful Christians, Dominic and Chanel, newly joined in holy matrimony, may always enjoy health and well-being, we pray to the Lord. That he will bless their covenant as he chose to sanctify the marriage of Cana and Galilee, we pray to the Lord. That they may be granted perfect and fruitful love, peace and strength, and that they may bear faithful witness to the name of Christian, we pray to the Lord. That the Christian people may grow in virtue day by day, and that all who are burdened by any need may receive the help of grace from above, we pray to the Lord. That the grace of the sacrament will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married persons here present, we pray to the Lord. We ask you, Lord, to graciously pour out upon this husband and wife the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing, whatever may divide those who have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite everyone to please be seated. frail are the offering made on the occasion, the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide us forth through Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. We have forged the covenant of marriage, the sweet yoke of harmony, and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish this wonder, this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their birth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without it, we acclaim. You therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which refuge firstly for your holy Catholic Church, be pleased to grant your peace to guard and unite and ever throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our bishop, and all those who hold in your truth, and on the Catholic Apostolic Church. Remember, Lord, your servant, and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For then we offer you this sacrifice of praise and the offerings for themselves and all who are here to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and say their homage to you, eternal God, living the truth, in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, and Sixtus. But in the sacred moments we saw in St. John and Paul, Cosmos, and Damien, and all your saints, we ask that through your merits and prayers and all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, the offering of your servants, Dominic and Chanel, and of your whole family, when we treat your majesty on their behalf, and as you have brought them to their wedding day, so gladden them with your gift of the children they desire, and bring them in your kindness to the length of days for which they hope. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless the knowledge and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before him, the Son took the bread and was holding them in his hands. His eyes raised to heaven, and he, O God, as Almighty Father, can you thank him, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat this. This is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hand, and once more gave me thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. servants and your holy people. Offer your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy one, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with this remaining kind of countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and offering our high priest Melchizedek our holy sacrifice as spotless victim. And we'll pray, we ask Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by hands of your holy angels, your offer of high, and by that all of us, through this participation, we offer to receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, your people with every grace and every blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray in all who sleep in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants and those sinners who hope in your blood and mercies, graciously grant some sharing fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, administer to each of their company not made our merits, but recognize your partner in Christ, O Lord, that we continue to make all these good things, O Lord, and sanctify them, fill them with life, and bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. We wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord, God of his servants, now married in Christ, they may mercifully pour out to the blessing of his grace and make of one heart and love by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, for man and woman in your image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrate the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant you foreshadow the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom the woman is joined to man, and the companionship they have in the beginning is endowed with one blessing, not fortified by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now in favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter Chanel, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Dominic, entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. Now, Lord, we implore you. May these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments made one in the flesh. May they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children. And grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Lord Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with the world, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you. pray that you should enter under my roof, that all who say the word of my soul shall be healed.
May you be blessed, your children, and souls of your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone.